Is this thing on? Hello? Oh, whoever's out there, hello. I am the token Sophia, ladies and gentlemen, and all that in between. Welcome. Welcome. I am token Sophia, also known as Mackenzie. I am the brand ambassador and drag extraordinaire all the way out here in Provincetown. We are so honored to have these girls back with us live here at the Pilgrim House and also out wherever they are. They are prepared and we are prepared to give you one hell of a show. So ladies and gentlemen, showtime is in 5 minutes. Fun fact, I didn't ever watch a single episode of The Golden Girls until I met these girls when they visited us in December. And picture it, a homosexual in his mid-30s who's never seen a Golden Girls episode. It's awful. Anyway, showtime in 5 minutes. Get your Venmos ready. Whatever that is, it sounds like a venereal disease. Anyway, I hope you're ready. Showtime, 5 minutes. We'll see you then.
Perky bosom, perky bosom, perky bosom.
She moved me like a gypsy. Her body got me tipsy. I should take a step back, fall back. This girl got me feeling risky.
Perky bosom.
She's ready for the taking. And I got the motivation. Cause when you see your dancers and dance, you might not come home from the cage.
And if you look, you fall in love. She got that ass, she make it clear. She leave you shook, and now you're hooked. The way she dance,
she gon' make you move to Miami. She gon' make you move. She gon' make you move to Miami. She gon' make you move. She gon' make you move to Miami.
Dirty dot trash.
She gon' make you move to Miami. She gon' make you move.
Dirty dot trash.
She gon' make you move to Miami.
Learning is part of my heritage.
She gon' make you move to Miami. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, we gon' party.
Her mother was
freaking
a slut too.
Every weekend, baby, we just getting
started. Her mother was a slut too.
Sigue te moviendo.
Was a slut too.
Todo te están viendo.
Was a slut too.
Damn, you got me, girl, that body's
her mother
like
was a slut
Bugatti.
Too.
And if you look, you'll fall in love. She got that ass, she make it clear. She leave you shook, and now you're hooked. The way she dance,
she gon' make you move to Miami. She gon' make you move.
Trying to find your underwear in the big pile.
She gon' make you move.
Her mother was a slut too. Her mother was a slut
too.
Sperm pusher.
Never happy, she said no hands, booty still clapping. She wanna be Eve, baby, here's an apple. Welcome to the booty shaking capital, MIA. Where the mummies on the chain, where the mummies get loose, where the mummies don't play, where their bodies like boom, and their booties like bang. That's what's up, man.
She gon' make you move to Miami.
Her mother was a slut too.
She gon' make you move to Miami.
And if you look, you fall in love. She got that ass, she make it clear. She leave you shook, and now you're hooked. The way she dance,
she gon' make you move to Miami. She gon' make you move to Miami.
Her mother was a slut too.
Ladies and gentlemen, and variations thereupon, your pals and confidants, the Golden K's NYC.
Thank you for being
brave. Oh, yeah.
Travel down the road, back
again. Hey, everybody.
So
thing?
Where did she go?
Did our music stop? Oh, our music is muted. Unmute the music, my darling Coco, please.
It was all going so well, wasn't it?
Oh, it was perfect, wasn't it?
I almost felt like we had a real show again.
It was amazing.
Let's just keep going.
This is where Donnie and Marie come in. Oh, girls, it's Donnie and Marie.
Donnie and Marie.
We've got to make it to the stage.
Donnie and Marie.
And then we go.
A 5, 6, 7, 8, and boom. A da, a da, 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 do. A di, a da, 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 boom. And then we do this. Ha, ha, ha. And then we do this. And then we laugh.
We look at each other. We laugh.
Oh,
we laugh.
And we laugh.
And we say, remember that? Oh,
God. That's amazing.
Hi there.
Thank you.
Oh, Pish Posh, yes. Please, we have a show to do. Hello, yes. Thousand Confidants.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I have my own applause track just in situations like this. If I need my own applause track, I can do it. Well, welcome everyone, you know, girls. Miami may be our homes, but Provincetown has our hearts. Holla, Pilgrim House! I'm sure that they're out there hollering, aren't they?
Something like that.
Yes, I think I hear hollering. Well, anyway, listen, my name is Dorothy Zbornak. And I have chronic fatigue syndrome. And this is my poodle, Penny, who is very upset that the neighbor is coming home to exercise in his yard. So I have this treat made of pork, which will help to keep him quiet. Anyway, my name is Dorothy Zbornak. I have chronic fatigue syndrome, so I'm going to sit. But I'm already sitting. So I'm going to lie down. This is my roommate, Blanche Devereaux.
Oh, hi, Dorothy. Hi, Penny. Hi, shirtless neighbor. Oh, this is Blanche Elizabeth Hollingsworth from Atlanta, Georgia. Then Blanche Elizabeth Devereaux from Miami, Florida. Hi, fellas.
Dorothy, her initials are B-E-D.
Her initials spell bed.
I'm confused.
Isn't my other roommate confused?
Oh, shush, Dorothy. Ladies and gentlemen in Facebook land, may I present Miss Rose Nyland, nay, Lindstrom, of the St. Olaf Lindstroms.
Hello, everyone. Guten Kaval, Provincetown, Steidel.
Uh-huh. I'm sure you're asking yourselves, how much do I have to pay to have these people turn off their Zoom video right now? Well, the answer is as much as you can. We're now taking donations via Venmo at the Golden Gaze NYC on PayPal, paypal.me/GoldenGazeNYC, or on our merchandise site. You go to the GoldenGazeNYC.com, click on merch, scroll down to ticket, and you'll see the Provincetown show ticket. You can click on that. Now listen, the reason that I am subjecting you to all of this information is whomever donates the most money between right now, 2:07 p.m. Eastern, and whenever this show ends, about 7 p.m., will win a Golden Girls fan prize package. So whomever goes on our Venmo, on our PayPal, on our merch site, donates $42, let's say, you will win a mystery Golden Fans prize, which I will announce at the end of the show. So please go on Venmo, on PayPal, or wherever you can, and we'll see who wins. Take it away, Blanche.
Oh, Dorothy, I can hardly stand the anticipation That was a musical theater reference for all you fans out there. Speaking of music, why, I have one more person I have to introduce to you. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for our fabulous music director, Mason Griffin. There he is. Hi, honey. How are you doing?
I'm great. How about you?
Fabulous. I like your little flower ensemble. It matches our backdrop a little bit.
That's right. That's right.
Oh.
All floral.
All florals, we're pretending we're out on the lanai in Miami today. Oh, I wish we were there. I wish we were with everybody in Provincetown this weekend. We were supposed to be up there at the Pilgrim House doing our show, Hot Flashbacks, but unfortunately, we're coming to you via Zoom, but that's all right. I have a fabulous announcement to make too. So, ladies and gentlemen, next Monday, not tomorrow, but the Monday after that, Monday, June the 1st, the three of us are bringing you our very first Stage It show. That's right. We're coming to you on Stage It, live and in person with our show, Hot Flashbacks, That Sex Story. Now, I'm really excited for this, so you do not want to miss it. I promise you. You can head on over to our website, get your tickets. They're only $10. Well, I can get a lot of things for $10. What can you get for $10?
Hopefully a new pair of underwear.
A new pair of underwear, perhaps. Maybe a little sweet tea from McDonald's. I could get 10 of those. So cheers to everybody. And this is going to be a fabulous show. I'm going to throw it over to Rose. Rose, what you got to say, sugar?
Thank you, Blanche. I'm so excited for our first ever Stage It show. Yay, I'm so excited. And I hope I win that raffle today on the Venmo and the PayPal. But I'm here to bring you a fabulous message. Do you have a loved one who is celebrating a birthday during quarantine or a bar mitzvah or a virtual baby shower? Well, you can send them a personalized video message from us, the Golden Gays NYC, via Cameo. That's cameo.com. And of course, you can join our Patreon, patreon.com/thegoldengaysnyc. For more information on that and our different four different monthly subscriptions, you can go to our website, thegoldengaysnyc.com, and click everywhere, click anywhere and everywhere to your heart's content.
Thank you, Rose.
You're welcome.
So what episode are we talking about today, girls?
Let's see. It's going to be season 2, episode 8, and it was called Vacation.
I want to be on one of those right now. Don't you, girls?
Oh, girls, wasn't that vacation before this whole mass quarantine, the Golden Fans at Sea cruises? Wasn't that just a vacation of a lifetime?
Oh, it sure was. I can't wait till next year, 2021. So all you golden heads out there who know this episode, season 2, episode 8, get your trivia caps on because we're going to be asking you some questions about it.
Mason, honey, could you give us a quick little rundown of what happened on season 2, episode 8 called Vacation? What did we girls get up to on that episode?
Well, the three girls leave town and leave Sophia at home, which is convenient for her because she gets to hang out with Mr. Matsumo, the gardener. And the three girls go on what they think is a beautiful little vacation getaway on a beach. This lovely hotel that's supposed to have a beautiful view of the ocean.
Allegedly, yeah.
You have to be a contortionist to hang out that window.
Quoting the show, I love it.
Yeah, so they run into a bit of trouble when they realize they also have to share their bathroom with three men.
Three men? Did you say three men?
Well, don't get
three men.
It's not the way you're going to spend your vacation.
It's not?
You said. Oh. But at any rate, they end up befriending them and they take a little midnight cruise that ends up throwing them in the middle of a storm. And they're shipwrecked on what they think is a deserted island, but it's actually just the other side of a resort.
And then it's all wrapped up in 23 and a half minutes.
In 23 exactly. and a half minutes, and Betty White sings, "I'd like to teach the world to sing in perfect harmony."
Oh, I love it. All right, so that's a nice segue into our first section, the Dorothy section. Hello, everyone. Hello, Bookface. I want to announce that we're live on our Bookface page, the Golden Gaze NYC, but you could also be viewing us over on the Pilgrim House Bookface page. Thank you to Mackenzie for making that happen for us. And then our other pals over at the page Queer Guru. Please go over to their Facebook page and check out everything that they're about. They're also broadcasting this show today. So, you know, the Golden Girls is all about friendship, and all of our friends here, there, and everywhere are showing their support of us. Thank you all so much. Now, let me head over to my notes. I don't happen to live with Mason Griffin like Blanche does, so I have to take notes about the episode. Now, the first thing that I wanted to chat about, I was doing a little studying earlier today, and I learned that Memorial Day, it used to be called Decoration Day. They called it Decoration Day, I think up until after World War I or II, when they changed it to Memorial Day. They called it Decoration Day because you would go and you'd decorate the graves of the fallen soldiers with a very specific flower. And this flower behind me is the red poppy. That's the Memorial Day flower. It comes from the poem In Flanders Fields, which John McCrae wrote. So that's why I have these beautiful poppies and Penny the Poodle here. So that's a little bit of Memorial Day trivia. You can test your pals and confidants and see if they ever knew that it was called Decoration Day. I didn't know. So about the episode, Vacation. Mason did tell us that three of the girls go off on what they hope is going to be a fabulous beach vacation. And so they leave my ma behind. And Sophia, ma, says that she's glad about it because she wants to blank in the nude while the girls are gone. So I'm gonna check over here on my Bookface Live, and please answer out. What was it that Sophia wanted to do in the nude while the girls were on vacation? And whoever answers, I'll send you a little something in your mailbox if you message me your mailbox address, okay? And I'm going to move on. Now, let's see, what else? Mr. Matsumo was the gardener. Mason went over that. Oh, okay, so they get to the iron. Jimmy Two Canes over here said she wants to iron in the nude. Tim Bell says she wants to tan in the nude. Kevin Edmonds said sunbathe. You're all wrong, but maybe someone will get it right. I know Mason knows, so I can always ask him. All right, so while I'm waiting for someone to tell me what they're going to what she wanted to do in the nude. What does that say? Pinned on the left, are they? Always get one when the guys are standing out. I don't know what that is, but I'm glad she said it. Okay, so there was a famous Latino comedian who played the bellboy. So they get to the hotel and he basically just throws their luggage on the bed. And I knew him as a stand-up comedian. Does anyone remember what his name was? Fess Parker, is he here? Oh no, that's me. I thought it was Fess Parker, but someone said garden in the nude. I never ask hard questions. People are always answering, but we'll see. Okay, so that's the name of a famous comedian. He was the bellboy. And then I think one of us posted a gif of the girls lying on the bed, and it's supposed to be a vibrating bed, but it doesn't actually work. And so then this actor comes in and he puts his foot on the bed and he just starts shaking the bed, and he sings a famous Cuban song, if anyone knows that. This is too hard. What was Sophia's first name? Please tell us. Anyone out there, do you know What was Sophia's first name? Her last name was Petrillo, and her first name, it starts with a so and ends with a fia, and cheesy. Watch TV and Cheech Marin. Estelle. Guantanamera. All right, Tim Bell is in it. Guantanamera. Very nice. Tim Bell wins. All right, Tim, I'm gonna mail you something in your mailbox. Now, the answer to that first question was Sophia wanted to vacuum. She wanted to vacuum in the nude. It sounds horrible. Okay, and one more question. At one point, I get to slap Rose in the face. Does anyone remember why I smacked her in the face? And it wasn't a St. Olaf story, even though I want to smack her in my mind. So while you're thinking about why would Dorothy smack Rose in the face? The neighbors are going by, so I have to get another treat for Penny so he doesn't bark while I sing. I'm going to sing a song. And, it looks like Alexa said a fly on her cheek, which is very, very close. It's a different insect, Alexis. But this is my Memorial Day song. I'm going to get my track all queued up here and sing my Engelbert Humperdinck song for you for Decoration Day, also known as Memorial Day. Lazy, hazy, crazy days of summer. Those days of soda and pretzels and beer. Roll out those lazy, hazy, crazy days of summer. Dust off the sun and moon and sing a song of cheer. Just fill your basket full of sandwiches and wieners. Then lock your house up. Now you're set. And on the beach you'll see the girls in their bikinis, but yet they never, ever, ever get them wet. Roll out those lazy, hazy, crazy days of summer. Those days of soda and pretzels and beer. Roll out those lazy, hazy, crazy days of summer. You'll wish that summer could always be here. Lazy, hazy, crazy days of summer. Those days of soda and pretzels and beer. Those lazy, hazy, crazy days of summer. Dust off the sun and moon and sing a song of cheer. Don't have to tell a girl or fella about the drive-in or some romantic movie scene. Right from the moment that those lovers start arriving, you'll see more kissing in the cars than on the screen. Roll out those lazy, hazy, crazy days of summer. Those days of soda and pretzels and beer. Roll out those lazy, hazy, crazy days of summer. Dust off the sun and moon and sing a song of cheer. You'll wish that summer could always be here. You'll wish that summer could always be here. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Oh, no, please. Thank you. And thank you to Penny the Poodle for not barking during my song. Here's Penny. It's hard to see him in the poppies, but here he is. He disappears. Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much. And please don't forget to donate. And right now, I'd like to reintroduce my mother, whose first name is Sophia. Here she is. Mosquito.
Hello. Beautiful job, Pussycat. Sweet, sweet deal. Remember, tip these beautiful women. They're working hard. They're your glorified strippers today. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here's Blanche.
Oh, thank you so much, Sophia. We'll see you. Where'd she go? Oh, I guess she went out with the gardener to have a little quickie on the lanai. Oh, my lantern. How are you doing, Mason? How's your day going?
Oh, it's just wonderful.
We're here in our little fake lanai and our little beach chair, just lounging around, wishing we were in Miami, wishing we were at the Pilgrim House. But here we are, sugar. What did you say we do a little cheers? We have our little glasses. We're pretending this is a tropical cocktail. I have some iced tea. Mm. Cheers to you out there, everybody. I hope you have a little mimosa. I hope you have something fabulous. We're going to do some trivia about the episode, all right? So put your thinking caps on. Question number one. This one, actually, we gave away a little bit earlier. So if you were listening, you're going to know it. It's real easy. Blanche tries to make the best of their crappy accommodations on this trip by trying out the what? Your options are A, a jacuzzi hot tub, B, a vibrating bed, C, the mini bar, or D, a dildockenschlangen. I wish it were D. I wish it were D. What do you think, honey? You have anything to say? What are your guesses over there? I mean, I know we actually said it about 5 minutes ago, so.
Well, yes, I'll say it takes about a quarter to get it going.
That's a very good clue. About a quarter to get it. It takes about three quarters to get me going. 75 cents for all three men in the bathroom. Quarter for each of them. What do we have over here? First person I see is Miss Alexis. Vibrating bed. You are correct, sugar. We love you, Alexis. You always know the answers. How about you ask the second question?
Honey? Sure. The three men that they share a bathroom with, rather inconveniently, they end up meeting them later in the lobby, and they apologize for their rude behavior towards the ladies. And one of them asks for this specific item to share with all the ladies. What is it he orders?
Hint, it's a drink from the bar. It's a type of drink, because he wants to apologize for their rude behavior. Mm-hmm. Here's a little bit of a clue as to what it could be. These lovely tall glasses. Also a bit of trivia. These are actually Mason and I's wedding champagne glasses. So they're really lovely. We thought we'd bust them out today for Memorial Day weekend. Anybody got some guesses out there? Hi, Cooper Jordan, all the way from Atlantic City. Do you have any idea what the answer could be? Let's see. How is Atlantic City, Cooper? How's it going down there? Tell us all the 411. Nothing yet, Roland. Let's go on to the next question and see while they roll in those answers. So question number three. They're stranded on a beach. Blanche tells Dorothy that she overheard her on the telephone tell Anita Rubaker that she had a tummy tuck. Is that true or false? Is that true or false? Jared Tall. That's incorrect, but good guess, Jason. Kevin, you are correct. It was a bottle of champagne. And if you want to get very specific, it was actually a magnum of their best champagne. A little iced tea. Oh, I have some iced tea now. Alexis says that was false. The third question. You are indeed correct, Alexis. It is false. For bonus points, while I'm singing my song, does anybody know what she actually overheard her tell? Let's see if they know that. I'm sure Alexis does. I think it's time for a little ditty. What do you think?
Let's try.
Should we give them the little setup?
Sure.
I think we should. All right, imagine, everybody, that we are at the Rusty Anchor. Everybody, can I have your attention, please? Two can play this game, Dorothy. Boys, girls, and everything in between. I've got a little surprise for you this evening.
Yeah, we know you're not wearing a bra.
No. I'm gonna sing! Oh my God! I'm gonna wear this red t-shirt and sing. Hit it, honey. I wanna be loved by you. Just you
and nobody else but you. I wanna be loved by you alone. Boo boo be doo woo! I wanna be kissed by you, just you and nobody else but you. I wanna be kissed by you alone. Boo boo be doo. I couldn't aspire to anything higher than to fill my desire to make you my own. Woo! I wanna be loved by you, just you and you and you and all of you, P-Town. I wanna be loved by you alone. Boo boo be doo. Oh, isn't there anybody out there in the land of the face of the book that I could be loved by? Let's see. Tim, that was a reveal, sugar. Thank you. You saw the real reveal on the cruise ship. This is the Gabe's version, the dollar store version. Oh, Tina, you are indeed right. Champagne was what they had. Who else do we have out there? Provincetown, we miss you so much. We can't wait to see you this summer. I think we gotta take this sucker home before we get cut off of Zoom. I wanna be loved by you, just you and nobody else but you. Oh, I wanna be loved by you. Oh my God, I'm on a bench. Alone. Oh my God, oh. The applause is deafening. Thank you so much. Thank you, Mason. That was fun.
Oh, I love Blanche.
That's a go-to Blanche number. We love doing it. So much fun. Oh, and the flying shoes. Tim, the flying shoes are indeed a fabulous part of that number. I miss it dearly. Anywho, we've got one more special treat for you tonight. So I'm going to throw it over to Miss Token Sophia to introduce Rose. Go for it, sugar.
Oh my God.
There she is. Hi.
Hello.
There.
Hello. Wasn't that great? What? I'm asking, was that great? I keep my hearing aids off when these girls start singing. But remember, tip them. I know that they're amazing. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here's Rose.
Oh, thank you, Ma. Well, thank you, everyone in the Facebook land, for joining us. This has been a wonderful, wonderful afternoon. And with my little section here, I'm going to read it. It says, Rose's turn, because here she is, boys. Rah! Here she is, world. Rah! Here's two Jews, an Arab, and a priest walk into a bar. And then it goes, well, anyway, this is when Dorothy cuts me off. I'm going to do my little trivia section now. So get ready. Thinking caps on. Question one. Who slept with Rose, with Rose's, that's me, Rose's cross-eyed cousin, Nolan, from Ohio? Who slept with Rose's cross-eyed cousin, Nolan, from Ohio? Yes. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Do-da-do-do. No, you keep, you, hush up, Blanchie. No. No. First one to get it. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Hello, Howie from Brooklyn. Alexis. I think it's a tie between Alexis and Tim, and they both said the correct answer, which is both Dorothy and Blanche. Yes, that is very correct. That is very true, very correct. Moving right along to question two. I, Rose, had plastic surgery. What did I also, let me read this the right way. Maybe if I turn my phone over, my internet phone over. Rose had plastic surgery. What did she have done? That's the correct English. What did I have done? And for extra points, how much did it cost? Rose had plastic surgery. What did she have done? And how much did it cost? Dun, 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 dun. Dun, 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 dun. Hello, Andrea. Jason B. Schmidt, who is that? $17 in Mexico. This necklace was $17 in Cozumel. Cozumel? Alexis, for bonus points, how much did it cost? How much did it cost? Got the right answer. That's true. So Alexis and Jason, that's correct. But the first one of you to say how much it costs wins the pie. Dun, 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 dun. I'll say it again. Rose had plastic surgery. What did she have done? Jason and Alexis got the correct answer, the first parter, which is a nose job. Yes, I did. I did have a nose job. How much did it cost? We have a tie. It's between Jason and Alexis. Battle it out in the center ring. Golden Girl style. Ding, 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 ding. Bring your depends. Oh, I'm sorry, Jason. I'm sorry, Andrea. No, it's not $1,500. We're going to move along. So Alexis and Jason, you've won that question. The correct answer for how much it cost was $700. It was a lot of money back in 1985. Question three, I sing a song. I'd like to teach the world to sing in perfect harmony. What product was the song? No English today. What product was that song a jingle for? As you can tell, I didn't write these trivia questions. What product was that song a jingle for? I'd like to teach the world to sing in perfect harmony. Da, da, da. And while we get to that last question, so think about that. I'll say it again for the balcony. I'd like to teach the world how to sing in perfect harmony was what jingle was what was from what jingle? I'm just going to stop talking and sing. That's what I'm going to do. Dorothy's laughing at me through the screen. I hope you get a hoot and a holler through this, girls. This is what happens when you don't eat before a show. Let me entertain you. Let me make you smile. Let me do a few tricks, some old and then some new tricks. I'm very versatile. And if you're real good, I'll make you feel good. I want your spirits to climb. So let me entertain you. And we'll have a real good time.
Yes, sir.
We'll have a real good time. All right. Gonna try to do this on Zoom. Oh! You know, I was watching a Mae West documentary while I was getting my makeup done today. She was the highest paid woman in Hollywood in 1935. Did you know that? The more you know. Dance break. And if you're real good, I'll make you feel good. I want your spirits to climb. So let me entertain you and we'll have a real good time. Yes, sir. Oh, we'll have a real good time. Come up and sing me sometime. I just love Mae West. She was the OG blonde bombshell before Marilyn Monroe and Jean Harlow and all those other broads. Mae West was the OG blonde bombshell. For all those young gays who don't think they need to know that. All right, thank you very, very much. Now we're gonna answer the last question. I'd like to teach the world how to sing in perfect harmony was a product, was the jingle for what product? I'm gonna check here on the Facebook land. Did anyone get it? Let's see. My comments. Very good. Yes. Whoever the first one it was to answer Coke, you are correct. Something's going wrong with my comments, but we'll make sure that we get you the prize or whatever it is you want. Thank you very, very much. And now I'd like to bring it back to our very special guest with a special number, ladies and gentlemen, and everything in between, the mother of the House of Pilgrim, it's Mackenzie! Wow!
Hi, darlings. Can you hear me okay? You found me? Hi, everyone. You guys, thank you so much. This has truly been an honor. On behalf of Pilgrim House, as the brand ambassador and drag queen that truly just, for some reason, they allow me to hang out there all the time now. It has been such an honor to have you guys back, even on our virtual stage. So ladies, thank you all so much. To everyone tuning in, thank you all so much for just having a good gay old time with us here with the Golden Gays. And on behalf of Pilgrim House, we miss you. We miss you all. It is a very, very different Memorial Day for us. I know for the most part, many of you probably come and have been out here and have seen the masses that we have here in Provincetown at this time. It's a very different world these days, but we thank all of you so much for your continued love, support, and patronage. You keep us golden, you keep us happy, you keep us healthy and alive, and we'll be back for you very soon. The ladies have been so sweet to ask me to sing a little song for you. So this is going out to all of you, whether you've been to Provincetown many, many years ago, or you just came last year for the first time, or you plan to in the future. What we really, really, you know, cherish are the memories that we have here in Provincetown. And we're gonna keep them going even after all is said and done. So ladies and gentlemen, to the new memories that we will make together, especially the memory that I will take away from this today, thank you all so much, and away we go. If you know, sing along. I wish we had a little bouncing Mickey Mouse thing at the bottom. But here we go, y'all, for you. We love you. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, because the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way, because the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back you. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feels like December, cause somebody says your name. Cause I can't reach out and call you, but I know I will one day. Call your people, y'all. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday. But everything gonna be all right. Go and raise a glass and say, hey, cheers to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, because the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way, because the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back yo. Do 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 do. The memories bring back yo. There's a time that I remember when I never felt so lost, when I felt all of this hatred was too powerful to stop. Now my heart is like an ember and it's lighting up the dark, and I'll carry these torches for you, and that you know I'll never drop. I never will, baby. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday. But everything gonna be all right. Go and raise a glass and say, hey, here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, because the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way, because the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back yo. Do 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 do. The memories bring back yo. Do 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 do. Sing with me. Do 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 do. The memories bring back yo. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Pilgrim House and everyone here in Provincetown, we miss you. We love you. Continue to remain safe and happy and healthy. And just know that we will be here for you when it comes time to get y'all back here. Happy Memorial Day, my golden gays. I love you all so much. Thank you guys endlessly. We'll see you very soon. Goodbye!
Oh my gosh.
Mackenzie, that was beautiful. If you guys enjoyed that as much as I did, I just literally ran over to Venmo during her song and I tipped that queen $5. Head over to her Venmo. It's just Mackenzie. Give that queen a couple bucks. That, I didn't know you could sing that well. That was gorgeous, darling.
Yes, very nice.
Amazing. Well, where are we at, girls? Are we at our quick little wrap-up time? Is that what's going on?
I think so. This has been a fabulous show. Thank you all so much for joining us. You're a pal and a confidant. Be sure to visit our website, thegoldengaysnyc.com. Have a wonderful and safe Memorial Day. I know it's very different this year, but we are still honoring all of those who have fought and continue to fight. And thank you for spending your afternoon with us. A quick reminder about ordering your cameos for your loved ones. We do all types of personalized messages, and we have a blast doing it, as well as please join our Patreon with our 4 different monthly subscriptions. And, you know, you can be a part of the magic. So thank you. Blanche?
Thank you, Rose. Thank you so much, everybody, for tuning in today. Extra special thanks to the Pilgrim House and David, the wonderful proprietor there. We love him. Thank you, Mackenzie, for setting this up. And thank you to Queer Guru all the way from Miami, Florida, for also partnering with us today. You guys were fabulous. What else? Oh, Stage It. That's right. So everybody, don't forget our next live show. We're actually taking tomorrow off to enjoy Memorial Day as well. But our next show will be the Monday after that, June the 1st. It's on Stage It, Hot Flashbacks, That Sex Story. I'm really excited. I can't wait to see you guys there. It's being co-produced by our friend Spin Cycle from the Laurie Beachman Theater. So look us up and we'll see you there. What do you got, Dorothy? We got a raffle winner?
Yes. Thank you, everyone who went on your Venmo, on your PayPal. Thank you to everybody who bought a virtual ticket to today's show. All of that stuff helps to, you know, keep us in costume jewelry and wallpaper paste for our faces. And it'll all help us to make a rip-roaring return to an actual physical stage with humans at some point. So I was scrolling through the donations and one of our number one fans from the Golden Fans at Sea Cruise, Patricia Shaffrey, made a huge donation over on our Venmo. So Patricia, she buys our merchandise all the time. So I'm not sure if she has this, but Patricia, if you hold it in front of my white outfit, if you don't yet have these Golden Girls ornament sets from our pals over at Night Owl Designs, I'll pop that in the mail for you, Patricia, and send that over to you. And if you do already have that, well, maybe I'll draw you a picture or something. But anyway, thank you everyone for being so supportive of us. And we'll see you at our Stage It debut on June 1st.
Shall we take it away, honey?
Let's do it.
I know you guys know this at home, so sing along. Here we go.
Thank you for being a friend. Travel down the road and back again. Heart is true, you're a pal and a confidant. And if you throw threw a party on Zoo. Invited everyone you knew.
10 people or less.
You would see the biggest gift would be from me. And the card attached would say, thank you for being a friend.
Thank you.
Bravo, everybody. Blanche. Bravo, Mason. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Mackenzie. Thank you, Pilgrim House. Mwah.
Shall thank we you. Take it home, girls?
Yes, I mean, I think in honor of these okay. white outfits that we're wearing, maybe Coco the chef can play a special game. I have this cute brooch that didn't make it into the view, but here, see.
These all white outfits out there, what do they remind you of, Facebook land? Yes,
Betty White.
Yes.
Betty Off-White?
Off-White. And...
maybe.
Don't tell me what to say, and don't tell me what
you remember. You don't own me.
Yeah.
Try to change me in any way. You don't own me. Don't tie me down, cause I'll never stay. I don't tell you what to say. I don't tell you what to do. So shut your lips.
Goodbye, pals and confidants. Thank you.
Love you. Happy Memorial Day.